Good night, Tom.
Good night, Grandad.
Good night, Felix.
Good night, Grandad.
Good night, Jeff.
Good night, Grandad.
Good night, Marie.
Grandad?
Yes?
We can't sleep.
Have you tried closing your eyes?
Of course.
Have you tried lying there quietly?
Of course.
Have you tried counting sheep?
Of course. Will you tell us what your story?
Of course. The story began in a huge old house on the edge of a city. Once the house would have light and life, but now it was full of dust and musty smells. There was a garden, but it was surrounded by a very high stone wall.
Is this the kind of story which might give me nightmares?
Of course.
Yes!
There's a grand old house. I'm a grand old lady. Contessa, they called her. But this story is not about the Contessa. It's about the cats who lived in her house. The cats have been living in the grand old house for many generations. Many years ago, their ancestor Janelle had settled in the house, and no cats had ever set foot or paw outside since.
What? Old house, old lady, and now poor old cats who don't even go out?
Old isn't always bad, Felix. Listen to your granddad and you might learn something. The cats were no ordinary cats. They were nature blues, Mesopotamian blues, and they were very proud of it.
Blue cats?
Mesopotamian blues.
Yeah. Where do you think you're going?
Aren't we even allowed in the garden now?
Sweetheart.
But Mum,
the garden is a nasty, dirty place. You are a pedigree cat, a pure bred Mesopotamian drink. What do you want out there?
Bunting. Aren't cats supposed to run? In the south of child report houses, shall I use to run?
Grow up by Jack. Tails are filled with kittens.
The lion lived a long time ago, dear, and the tales also tell us that outside there are huge monsters. They call them dogs. They are so fierce that even humans are scared of them. Count yourself lucky that we have never met one. Anyway, Jalal came to live in this house a long time ago. The contestant looks after us. She loves us. She feeds us.
She loves some of us. When I was a little kitten, the contestant used to come downstairs all the time. She even used to let me play around. Now she only ever comes downstairs to feed us, and she doesn't do that very often anymore. In fact, I haven't seen since Bar Jack was born. It's because of his eyes. The Mesopotamian beings have green eyes. Bar Jack's eyes are amber, colour of danger. Bar Jack is an embarrassment.
You're a liar, Julia.
Bar Jack poor.
That's no way to talk to a brother.
Julius, you should tease Bar Jack so much. The contestant is not coming down because she's ill. Nothing more. Bar Jack, you must learn to be a proper Mesopotamian blue like the rest of us. We don't go around calling each other liars. We don't go around talking about disgusting things like hunting. And we don't go getting our paws muddy in the garden. Do you understand?
Bar Jack, your father is talking to you.
Fine. Until you can learn to be a proper Mesopotamian blue like the rest of us, there'll be no supper for you. Come on, everybody. Let's go to the kitchen.
See you later, insect.
Yes, I'm cool.
I'm glad you like the tales to tell about Jamal. I'll tell you another one later if you like.
Thanks, Ericol. I'd love that.
Nothing ever happened here. Everyone is mean to me. I feel alone in the middle of my own family. What the...
Now, everyone must attend, even the kittens.
Jesus when Alexander the Great came out of Mesopotamia. He wandered the earth for many years until finding his home here with the Contessa. Generations have lived in this house since the last time. However, those days may be coming to an end. I believe that the Contessa is dead. She's hardly left the room lately. The younger kittens barely know her. She wouldn't have let that happen unless something was seriously wrong. Now that this gentleman has appeared, I'm afraid she's gone.
Yes, she's gone somewhere and left her gentleman friend behind.
He's not her friend. I remember years ago when he used to visit, the Contessa threw him out. She hates him. Why is he being so nice to us now? What about those cats which Garjack saw?
In the meantime, the Contessa will be back. And we all know Garjack tells tales. And now we thought probably a second confusion is already.
But it's true. I saw them. I swear in the name of Jalal.
Shut up, insect.
Listen, everyone. We need a plan. If things keep changing in the house, we're going to have to go outside.
Outside? But outside is full of monsters. At least in here we're safe from dogs.
We don't even know what dogs are. None of us have ever seen one. Just listen.
No, you listen to me for a change. Maybe it's time for someone else to make the decisions in this family. This meeting's over. Let's go. See what you've done with your stupid tail, insect. No wonder the contestant is gone. Nobody would want to live with you.
Thank you.
But he walked bravely towards the light and the noise and the dirt and the snuff of the world he couldn't possibly understand. Eventually, he came to a road.
Deafening sounds and foul breath. This must be the dog from the old tales of Joao.
Oh.
ones. What he needed some food though. There was no contestant or gentleman to feed about here and in the city, and besides, now he knew the weren't allowed, he could go hunting.
Gangster cats.
As I want through the night.
crazy or something. As if I could make her do anything.
Marjorie spent a few days with his new friends Holly and Tam. They tried, but their life was hard. He often thought of the family back at the Contessa's house and how easy their lives were. But that reminded him of the gentleman who was feeding them food. Marjorie was supposed to be saving them by bringing back a dog, but even though he knew the word Jalal, he had failed his attempts at talking to dog, and he could never go back without one. His family already hated him. No, Tam was nice. She was funny, but maybe not the smartest cat in the world. And she was always thinking about food. Marjorie liked Holly. He thought she was liking too. But Holly was tough. She didn't give much away. But Tam and Holly always seemed to lead Marjorie back to the same set of values. They called them the Sea Tallies. One evening, Marjorie asked why.
We call them the Sea Tallies because they're alleys and they're a secret.
These alleys are the only place where we are safe.
Safe? Who from?
Or what from? The vanishings for a start. Cats all over the city vanishing every day. One minute a cat's here, the next they're gone.
Where?
That's a mystery, Marjack. If we knew that, maybe we could do something about it. Ours is not a good friend. Even Ginger Skunk lost some cats. Then there's the gangs themselves. Ginger Skunk on the east side, and the gangs on the west.
Don't say her name!
Don't be stupid.
She's not one of us. She's something else.
She can do things like a cat can do.
Like what?
She can become invisible and just appear out of thin air. That's why nobody can beat her in a fight.
Them's tails, Marjack, and I don't believe any of them.
She's the toughest cat in this city, though. Even Ginger is scared of Sally Bones.
Don't say her name!
Her grandma's ordering all the food now. They're even moving around Ginger's patch. That's why we need to keep places like this a secret. Promise me you will never, ever, ever tell anyone about the secret Sally's, Marjack.
I promise. I won't let you down. You're one of us now.
Let's get ready for colour. You can't beat street colour.
Did someone mention food? I'm starving.
Why don't we go hunting?
Ha! Hunting. Hunting comes as easy as you look to some house cat. That's where we're all spending around the bins. How did you know how to hunt?
I got taught a few tricks once. A relative.
I'd love to see a pet cat go hunting and I'm really hungry. Let's go and see what we can find. Oh, and Tam, one more thing. Sally Bones!
Ah! Hunting.
What?
Nothing. I think I sent a mouse or something down that alley.
No, Marjack. You can't go down there. That's her territory.
No, Marjack, come back quick. If anyone finds me now, you'll be done for.
When you stalk your friend, you'll become your friend. Hello, little mousey. I'm sorry, but I have to eat.
That was pretty impressive, Marjack. Pretty stupid, more like.
Don't say her name!
Let's check this bar of your food!
Quick, Holly, it's racing in the gang!
What?
She's not joking, Marjack. These guys work for Sally Bones and bring Marjack into their territory.
Probably I'll see you there. Hello, Holly.
Hi.
Who's your friend?
I've not seen him around before.
I'm Marjack. No one was talking to you.
Nothing to worry about. He's one of us. He's just the pet who got lost.
Come and join our gang. We'll keep you safe from the vanishing. Sally Bones wants to have her own gang members.
Thanks, Razor, but no thanks. I've never really been interested in gangs.
Come on, I've always liked you. You can really be someone in the gang.
She said no!
We warned you, poor Jack, whatever your name is.
Suit yourself, Holly, but make sure you stay out of our territory.
Where is he? I'll beat him up.
No, Marjack, you can't go fight against Razor. There's only one cat in the city who could. Let's go back to see the tallies. But I'm starving. Can't we just go for one quick mouse? We could be really quick. The gang won't be around this way for a while.
Don't be stupid. I know you're hungry, but you shouldn't let you go your wee brain. It's not safe.
Please? I'm going. Suit yourself. We'll see you back at see the tallies later.
The problem was, Tam didn't meet them back in the secret any later, or the next day, or the day after that.
Did Sally Bones get up? Was it the vanishings?
Who knows, but Marjack and Holly will both really set off looking for her.
Where is she? She can't have just vanished.
Really, this is serious, Marjack. I think we need to head into Sally Bones' territory to look for Tam. Will you come with me?
Of course I will. We're friends. What's that noise?
Keep it in the bins. That's all. We have no time for chasing mice, Marjack. That's what got us into this trouble.
That's not a mouse.
and you always look cute. Not like us.
Happy, happy, happy.
It sounds strange, and it moves strange, but it looks so real.
Look at the fur.
Yes, Guard Jack. Toadlings are very clever. Can we keep looking for the real Tam now?
I will be your friend forever.
There's definitely something weird about that cat.
There's definitely something weird about you. We don't hold against you.
This is hopeless, Holly. We've been searching for hours. I'm tired. Can we stop for a quick cat nap?
In Sally Bones' territory.
I want to help, but we can't when we're this exhausted.
A quick cat nap, that's all. Charge? Far Jack, is that really you, sweetheart? He's back.
We thought he was lost forever.
He's grown.
Welcome back, Old Jack.
Things have changed around here since you've left. I'm head of the family now. Your dad was for a little while, but now I'm the
child
around
here. Have you been, Old Jack?
It's a long story. Some people might not even believe it. Things have been great around here without you. The gentleman is feeding us better than ever. The gentleman loves us.
The gentleman's cat's killed Elder for.
You're lying, Gabe. Admit it.
Let's not argue, sweetheart. Look how much you've grown. And you've got scars.
Oh, I had a few fights.
Scars, Jack, you're not a kitten anymore.
He's still a pigeon, and he's still a lion. You're not even a real Mesopotamian bloke, are you, Inchef?
Don't call me that.
It was a beautiful morning.
Yes, air was
course.